Welcome back, gamers. The doctor's in. I'm here with Johnny Mono.
What's up, everybody?
We're gonna play some Fix It Felix.
Fix It Felix? That sounds like that might be some kind of a weird movie tie-in.
Maybe.
Isn't that like Frozen or something?
Something like that.
Let it go!
We don't want to get flagged.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Don't let it go!
So, someone went and actually made the game that's within the movie. It's very meta.
Yeah, the movie that we're not going to name.
But the game's called Fix It Felix.
Yes.
My only gripe is you cannot skip the intro. That's about 10 to 15 seconds.
But you know, it is that all-important background. You know, you gotta have the story so that you understand why you're trying to fix everything.
Mm-hmm.
So this is really a story of oppressing homeless people and gentrifying a neighborhood.
Sounds like Portland.
Yes, absolutely. Felix is the bad guy then.
Maybe. Or is it the resident?
I think it might be.
Well, I'm gonna wreck it. Remember, violence is always the answer.
Well, see, his wrecking is actually just an art install, and the fact that they're trying to, correct the art is actually doing him a disservice.
Fix it, Felix! So someone actually went and programmed this. It's all for the Genesis. And I'm surprised it never had an NES version.
Yeah, that is really surprising. It seems like it would have been perfect for it. Although I will say that the Genesis gives it a little bit more power and makes it look like a very nice arcade game from the era. So it seems as though it would have been something that you could have played in the 80s.
So eating pies makes you invulnerable.
Yeah, if only it worked that way in real life. Oh my goodness. I feel very vulnerable when I eat a whole pie.
I won't judge.
Nice. Now what fascinates me is the fact that you're fixing windows with a hammer.
It's a magic golden hammer.
Yeah, but even still.
A hammer, nonetheless. Now, the game gets harder later on. I believe Ralph can actually re-break the windows. And birds come into play that look like the Duck Hunt ducks.
Yes, exactly.
And that's what I plan on doing most of my dying. It's I'm going to get trapped between bricks and ducks.
Yeah, it's as if the Duck Hunt duck met the Medusa head from Castlevania, and what you get is their unholy hellspawn in this game.
Yeah. Also, the only thing I don't like is he throws down bricks. I cannot go down to that floor or that shelf and land on top of the bricks.
Yes, must avoid the bricks at all costs in any way, shape, or form. Now see, I learned from various science programs as a youth that if you drop a brick and you drop something else, as long as there isn't wind resistance, they fall at the same rate. So the fact that Felix falls faster than the bricks is a little bit strange to me. It's as if they forgot their physics lessons.
Mm. I think it's at, 32 feet per second per second? Or that's, something else.
Yeah, I can't say that I'm familiar, but...
skydiving.
Oh, yes. Something that I plan on never doing. My fear of heights kicks in a little bit there.
Felix is pretty high up. The fourth floor.
Oh, there's that duck.
Now, there was an official licensed iOS game and mobile for this, and I played the heck out of that.
Now, that seems like that would be very difficult to do with touch controls.
Mm. Yeah, it wasn't the best. I definitely like having the controller. Now, there's also licensed cabs Disney made.
Oh, those things are awesome looking, too.
Most of them stayed at Disneyland proper and were used as promo in the Star Arcade, I believe. But a couple made its way out. There were some contests and giveaways, and you can get a real cab. Also, many people have went and programmed their own and done like a homebrew version of the cab.
Now, I'm not sure which it is that I've seen. I know that somewhere here in Portland, somebody had a cabinet. I'm not sure if it's official or if it was a homebrew style. Either way, the thing was beautiful. It looked awesome. So it was at one of the local arcades that I've been to.
And it kind of looks like a Donkey Kong machine.
Yeah, it definitely has that flavor, which makes sense. I mean, that's kind of what they were going for, and they captured it really well.
I just haven't seen a good version of this for, like, MAME or for arcade proper. I'd like to have that on my multi-cade, my future cade.
Ah, yes, that would be nice.
That BS duck right there, I mean, I knew it was coming, but things that jump off from across the screen that you don't have a little warning for, was thought are cheap deaths in video games.
Oh, such as?
Such as, and you can't control your direction once you commit the going down or up.
That's right.
You make the full movement.
And you gotta own it.
You can't slow down like Mario, you can't control the jump.
Now see, I don't really encounter that many ducks in my day-to-day life, but I wonder if they really are as aggressive towards humans as video games lead me to believe.
Geese are pretty mean.
Geese are just total jerks in real life?
They're very territorial. I'm not saying I've been chased by a goose or two, but they're not cool.
I'm glad that all I have in my neighborhood is squirrels.
Ooh, that was all luck.
Look at that. Skills. Pure skills. So I'm also guessing that this game must occur during the springtime, because I don't see any window units as far as air conditioners in this. Doesn't seem to be winter time, because we obviously don't have any snow going on.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, look at that. Only 7 seconds left, too.
7 seconds. I'm not quite sure how far this game goes on. Oh, no.
Oh, right into the duck. The answer is the game goes that far. Oh, nice.
It's a Billy Mitchell reference, if you think of that.
I catch what you're throwing.
You want to give a shot?
I'll give it a go. Let's see what we can do here.
Now, this is a Fix-It Felix Jr. proper. This isn't Fix-It Felix.
Oh, okay. I assume that Fix-It Felix would be the full-size cabinet.
No, maybe.
Oh, yeah?
I think the game is actually supposed to be Fix-It Felix Jr.
Oh, that's right.
Like Donkey Kong Jr.
Yes, okay. I wonder if the sequels will ever shed some light on the original Fix-It Felix.
I heard they're actually making a second Wreck-It Ralph movie.
I did hear about that as well, yeah. I guess he escapes into the internet, which is going to be pretty amazing.
There's a joke in there somewhere.
Yeah. Let's see, what I'm wondering is if we do get any news on the original Felix as opposed to Felix Jr., are they just going to refer to him as Cranky from that point on?
I see what you did there.
And will there be a Felix rap?
Of course. And Felix VHS.
Yes. And Felix will get a coconut gun for some reason?
Yeah.
And if he shoots you, it's gonna hurt.
I enjoy is, so the out of order screen for in the arcade in the movie, that's a lot of arcades actually use that out of order sick arcade cab.
Oh, yeah.
Nowadays, I think Corridor World does that and maybe Ground Control, but I've definitely seen it out. And it's very nice, very meta what they use from the movie.
That is excellent.
You're at a little advantage. The camera for me is directly in the middle, so the three middle windows I can't see.
For those of you at home that don't see, we're actually recording this on an old Betacam, and we found some of the tapes for it at a Goodwill locally, But the camera is actually taking up about five-eighths of the screen, I would say, you know. If you're going to have some retro videos, you got to have retro equipment.
I might be mistaken, but I think I might have seen some retro commercials for this or the arcade in the movie.
I'd have to go back and watch. I don't recall offhand.
Yeah, so I think it was like promo material that they did, like fake commercials for the fictitious arcade for the Wreck-It Ralph movie.
That's so awesome. And I miss video game commercials.
Yes.
Do you remember when Street Fighter 2 came out for home consoles?
Yes.
So they had those awesome, awesome commercials where they had live actors playing as if they were the Street Fighter characters.
Okay.
And the dude that played Guile was not very flattering.
9 seconds.
Oh yeah, we got this.
Now, I don't know how I got signed up, but I got signed up for a lot of the Toys R Us VHS tapes at the time.
Oh, nice!
So, I had Nintendo Power, but like, when Donkey Kong came out, or the Super Nintendo Donkey Kong.
Ah, no!
The Windows, you can't go left or right.
Oh, is that what that is?
Yeah, the shutters.
Oh, okay.
And there's a window sill so you can't go down or up.
Oh, gotcha. I was wondering. I was like, is your controller going funky on me?
No. It's increasing the difficulty. So, long story short, I would get these promo tapes, and I don't know if I still have them. I did the great purge of getting rid of all of my childhood, mistakenly.
Oh, goodness.
But...
And that's why everything's expensive now.
Yes. But they were great. And they really got you pumped. Like, I love Nintendo Power, but for me, like, Nintendo Power and the manuals, when you got a game, like, you just come through it and you read it over and over again. But the videos were awesome, and they usually had a really cheesy story.
Oh, of course.
So we got the pie, so now you're invincible.
All right, let's take advantage of that.
I think there was one. Oh, I don't remember. Like, oh, Mario.
This is getting tricky.
Oh,
I am done. Here we go.
Mario gets kidnapped. I'm trying to remember. It was some famous promo. Maybe you guys know. It's either like a Mario Kart or something.
So Mario is missing, perhaps?
No. It's like Sega and Sony get together.
Oh!
The mascots, like, in, like, big... Either they're, like, big mascots or, like, just dudes in shirts that had, like, the company names. And they're like... Oh, we got the plumber.
That's
kidnapped
awesome.
Him. It was so bad.
Oh, that sounds great. It reminds me of the Crash Bandicoot commercials.
Okay, that might be what I'm thinking of. It's all the 90s. It was a
awesome.
Weird haze for me.
Yeah, Crash Bandicoot had these awesome commercials where he would stand outside the Nintendo building and
okay.
He would have a megaphone.
Oh, yeah. I remember those.
Those were great. And then he ended up on the Wii anyway. What are you going to do?
You know, I don't think I've actually played more than 10 minutes of a Crash Bandicoot game ever.
I don't think you're missing much, honestly. I played a little bit of the original when it first came out on the original PlayStation 1. I played the remake on PlayStation 4, and I don't know. I mean, the game just never grabbed me. I don't think it's up my alley.
Yeah, for PlayStation right now, I'm going back and playing most of the stuff on my Pi. I didn't have a PS1, I think my earliest one was a PS2, so I don't have that attachment.
I was a Sega Saturn kid. I will say, I want to go back and try some of the Spyro the Dragon games. I've heard that those are really good, and I've learned to really like Spyro by playing all of the Skylanders games.
Okay.
So maybe those are something I should check out.
There's a... say a good Spyro collection on PS3. Oh.
Is it an HD remake?
I want to say it. I don't know if it's like a collection of three games or it's an HD remake of one game.
Oh, HD would be nice. I would like that.
For a while.
Oh, that duck!
But for a while I was going through and getting like all the Sly Cooper collection, PS3.
Oh, Sly Cooper's so good. I love that game.
Ratchet & Clank. Another game that I haven't spent enough time with that everyone seems to love.
Ratchet & Clank?
Ratchet & Clank.
I think I've only played on PSP. I had a bundle pack that came together when they first released the slim model of the PSP.
Okay. Yeah, Ratchet and Clank and Sam and Max, to me, always seem to go hand in hand. Maybe it's the mascots.
Oh, could be. Sam and Max is fantastic.
I have a bunch on Steam I got one time.
Nice.
And I still have yet to put the time in.
That's as far as I got. Well, that is a fantastically fun game. It definitely reminds me of the old arcades. It captured the feel very well.
Definitely. And even the title screen where it has the fake copyright.
Yeah, exactly.
And then we just realized Papa Smurfs from USA.
Pretty awesome.
There's a lot of love that was made into this game.
Absolutely.
If you guys are interested in getting a copy, there's contact information in the description below. But Fix It Felix Jr., as always, I'm the Doctor.
This is Johnny Mono.
Thanks for watching.
Cheers, everyone.